Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm going to explain some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. One of the most common interview questions in Angular is, what is the difference between string interpolation and property binding? If the interviewer asks what is the similarity of these two, many people can answer easily. But when the interviewer asks the difference, many people struggle. In this video, I'm going to explain the similarity, differences, and when should we use string interpolation and when should we use property binding. I have created an Angular application, installed Bootstrap, and have started the server. In the app component HTML, let me delete the existing code and add a container div. Inside that, I'm going to have two heading tags. In the app component ES, I'm going to create a variable channel name equal to webtechtalk. Now let me show that in template. In the first heading tag, I'm showing it using string interpolation, and in the second heading tag, I'm showing it using property binding. To be more specific, I'm binding it to the inner text property. Let's preview. So the similarity is both are used to show the data from TypeScript component into HTML view. One-way data binding from component to view. But what is the difference? We are not visually seeing any difference. Even if we inspect, we couldn't see any difference. Let's see another example with image. Let me grab an image URL. In the first div, let me show this in an image tag using string interpolation. And in the second div, let me show this using property binding. Let's preview. No difference here too. Let's see another example. I'm having a Boolean property is disabled, for which I have used true. Now in HTML, let me add two buttons. For the first one, let me use string interpolation to disable the button, and for the second one, let me use property binding. Let's preview. Both buttons are disabled. Perfect. So no difference, right? No, there is a difference. Let me change true to false. So we may expect both buttons to be enabled. But it is not. The reason is the string interpolation always transforms the data to a string. So the button will be disabled always, irrespective of whether the value is going to be true or false. This is the main difference between string interpolation and property binding. This also answers the question when to use string interpolation and when to use property binding. To set an element property to a non-string data value, you must use property binding. Otherwise, you can use either string interpolation or property binding. Now let's also see when not to use property binding. In particular, inner HTML property binding. Assume I have a form in which I have a form control to get the user input through a text box. And a submit button to submit the form. Now I'm showing all the user inputs one by one. Maybe a feedback section for a product. Let me show it using property binding as well as string interpolation, just for a demo. In the component, let me introduce the comments variable and also add the submit function. Now when an user types something, it will be pushed into the comments array and will be shown in the page. If the user is a hacker, he can use some HTML code to highlight his comment. So here we can avoid using property binding. Hope you understand the difference now. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.